everyone. In this video, we are going to learn the different suturing techniques practiced in oral surgery. The first suturing technique is simple interrupted suture. This is the most widely used technique for skin as well as oral mucosal closures. It is called interrupted because the sutures aren't connected, they are separate. So even if one suture fails, the others hold the wound in place. First, you load the curved needle with suture material in the needle holder, which is held at junction of distal 2/3 and proximal 1/3. Lock the needle holder to keep the needle fixed and stable. Lift the tissue on one side of the wound gently using a tissue holding forceps and pierce it at a 90-degree angle, which is 3 mm away from the wound margin. Make the needle rise out from the middle of the wound. It is then pierced on the opposite side of the wound at the same distance and depth as of the first pierce. Then pull the suture material through the wound, leaving only 3 to 4 cm at the tail end for knot tying. To tie a knot, the one which we are making here is surgeon's knot. Make 2 loops known as throws around the needle holder and grasp the tail end of the suture material. Pull the tail through the loop until the knot is tightened firmly. This is the first knot. Make sure to keep the knot at the side of the wound and not on the wound margin. After this, make one more loop of the suture around the needle holder in opposite direction as that of the first two loops. Again, grasp the tail end of the suture and pull it through to complete the surgeon's knot. Now, hold both ends of the suture material and cut the ends, keeping suture tags of 4 to 5 mm. So here is your completed simple interrupted suture. The second suture technique is figure of 8. This is typically used in closure of extraction sockets. Any extraction socket will have 4 interdental papilla. 1. Mesiobuccal papilla. 2. Mesiolingual papilla. 3. Distobuccal papilla. And 4. Distolingual papilla. First, you pierce the mesiobuccal papilla followed by mesiolingual papilla. Once the suture material comes out through mesiolingual papilla, you cross the extraction socket diagonally. Then you enter through distobuccal papilla and then exit through distolingual papilla. All this while, the tail end of the suture material lies at the first entry point, that is the mesiobuccal papilla. Once the fourth piercing is complete, the material is taken across the socket towards the mesiobuccal papilla and the surgeon's knot is tied. The end is cut, leaving 4 to 5 mm suture tag. So this is how a completed figure of 8 suture look like. The next suture technique is horizontal matres. This type of suture may be used to close deeper layers of wound and it provides better eversion of skin with less prominent scar. This is the first entry point, which is marked 1. So here the needle pierces the skin. The needle is passed beneath the skin and it emerges out on the opposite side of the wound. So the first step is similar to that of simple interrupted technique. So you have a first entry point here on one side of the wound and first exit point on the opposite side of the wound. You then have the second entry point 1 centimeter away from the first exit point, that is where it is marked 3. You enter the tissue again at the second entry point and then it exits the tissue on the other side at point 4, which is the second exit point. So in total you have 1, 2, 3, 4 piercings. The suture is then secured with a knot, surgeon's knot. So this is horizontal matrix suture. The next suture technique is vertical matrix suture. It is similar to simple suture, but an additional bite is taken through the wound edge for edge aversion. The first pierce or bite in a vertical matrix is taken deep and slightly more away from the wound margin when compared to that of a simple interrupted suture. Here I have marked the points where the needle enter and exit the tissue. Points 1 and 3 are entry points. Points 2 and 4 are exit points. The suture first enters the tissue through point 1. And emerges out on the opposite side of the tissue to point 2. So both the bites are of same depth and equidistant from wound margin. The needle is then reversed and returned with a very small bite through point 3, which emerges out on the other side of the tissue through point 4. You then tie a knot, a surgeon's knot. It is the two superficial bites near the dermal edge that helps in close approximation of the wound edge. So here the first two bites are deeper and farther from the wound edge, that is points 1 and 2. The third and fourth bites are superficial and nearer to wound edge. The advantage of vertical matrix suture is that it helps in reducing dead space and provides greater strength across the wound. It also doesn't interfere with healing of tissues as the suture runs parallel to blood supply. Moving on to next suturing technique, simple continuous suture. This provides a rapid, secure closure with an even distribution of tension along the length of wound. So this prevents excess tightening in any one area. This also provides better wound edge aversion and also watertight closure. The first step is to make a simple interrupted suture at one end of the incision line. So this is similar to the one which we have made in the first exercise. The only difference is that the excess suture material is kept the same length. You don't cut away any excess suture material. Keep it in its original length. After you have tied a surgeon's knot, continue taking bites on either side. Continue it for the entire length of the incision. Finally, you will end up with diagonal lines across the incision or the wound length. This way. When you reach the final suture, this is your final suture, this is your final bite. So when you reach the final suture, do not pass the material completely through the skin. This is the suture material which passes through the skin. Do not pull it completely through the skin, but leave this loop loose for you to tie the knot. Here you are tying a knot. Once you have tied the knot, you cut the end of the suture, leaving 4 to 5 mm of tissue tag, suture tag behind. So this is how a completed simple continuous suture look like. The advantage of simple continuous suture is that it is quick to make and has fewer knots. Disadvantage is that it is not possible to free just one suture at a time. Even if one suture breaks, the whole closure is effective. So this is about simple continuous suture. Moving on to locking continuous suture. This suture is similar to continuous suture, but with an added advantage that a degree of locking is provided by withdrawing the suture material through its own loop. The first step in continuous locking suture is similar to that of simple continuous suture, wherein you make a simple continuous suture with surgeon's knot with the longer end of suture material uncut. Then you go on suturing continuously, with each suture being placed at a distance of 1 cm from each other. After every second bite, as you move the suture material through the skin, make sure it is not passed completely through the skin, but leave a loop like this. Leave a loop so that you can pass the needle through the loop before pulling it out completely. As you can see here, I have taken the needle through the loop. So here I get a little square in the suture pattern. Pulling the needle out through the loop is the only step that differentiates simple continuous suture from that of locking continuous suture. Once you have sutured along the length of the incision, and you take the final bite, do not pull the thread completely through the skin. Instead, make use of this loop to tie the final knot. Same as you did for simple continuous suture. Then tie the suture end to keep suture tag of 4 to 5 mm. So this is your completed locking continuous suture, and here is your simple continuous suture. You can compare both of them. So the advantage of locking continuous suture is that due to locking mechanism, the tissue align themselves perpendicular to the incision. It also prevents continuous tightening of the suture as wound closure progresses. So that's all for this video about suturing techniques. Thank you.